Hi Gemini, it's Maria DeSimone from insightfulastrology.com, and I'm back with your monthly video horoscopes. Welcome. This is different. I know you're used to the production crew. There's no more of that. Now we're hanging out in my house, my dining room table, filming this on my computer. And this is an experiment. I know that I'll have to be tweaking this, but what I wanted to do was get back to talking to you guys about your astrology. I know that a lot of you have missed the monthly videos and me talking to you about your astrology. So let's get to it. Okay. I want to talk to you about May, because Gemini, May is huge. May is no joke. Okay. There's a major cosmic shift happening. The planet Uranus, which is all about revolution and just liberation and chaos and instability. This planet is moving into your most hidden 12th house on May 15th. And until November 6th, Uranus is going to hang out here and give you a taste of what it is about to bring your way in terms of radical changes. And Gemini, for you, these radical changes have everything to do with your spiritual development and your need for privacy, and to kind of honor the weirdo within you, but to do it in a subdued, quiet way. So what do I even mean? Okay, well, let's backtrack. The 12th house is known as your blind spot in your birth chart. Okay, we don't see what's in our 12th house clearly. Other people might, but we don't. And it is the area that has to do with a great need for solitude and privacy and reflection and spirituality. It's also known as the house of self-undoing sometimes, because we tend to cause trouble for ourselves when we're not seeing things clearly. And when Uranus is going into your 12th house now, you might be a little blind to some of the instability and chaos that's coming your way in your life. And don't think that that instability and chaos is negative, but I almost want to say that you might turn a blind eye to it. You might choose to ignore something that's going on in your world that is a little unsettling. Okay. And maybe you need to, no judgment. Maybe you need to. And it's just something to kind of take note of. Perhaps you're going to be doing this for a little while. The other thing with Uranus going to the 12th house is that your personal weirdness, your personal unusualness is now more reclusive and private. So you might be very interested in cultivating a spiritual, a metaphysical talent, maybe even learning astrology or numerology or some kind of metaphysical tool in a deep way, very deep way. You might spend hours and hours on your own studying something like this, and it can become just so incredibly profoundly fulfilling for you. And I would love to see you guys use this transit in that way. Because Uranus is going into your 12th house, but Uranus rules your 9th house of mind expansion, higher learning. And so there's a natural complement here that I'm seeing to you getting a strong interest now in an unusual topic that you want to master, that you really want to learn as much as you can about. So go for it. May 15th is when this transit happens. Now, also on May 15th, there's a new moon in the same area of your chart, your 12th house. So a greater need for privacy, honor it, a greater need to kind of just do your own thing and have that spiritual soul searching and do whatever needs to be done to recharge your spiritual batteries now. And for you, again, it's going to have to do with something unusual. And Uranus does also rule technology. So for some people, there's something related to technology with this. Maybe you're going to do some kind of online class that you're devouring, and that would be a great way to use this energy. So interestingly enough, Gemini, on May 16th, Mars, the planet of action and energy, will actually move into your 9th house. And is going to remain in your ninth house for quite a while, since he'll turn retrograde on June 26th. But for now, when Mars enters your ninth house, there's this stimulus, this energetic impulse for you to broaden your horizons in some way. The ninth house is higher learning of all types, including advanced degrees, certifications, licenses. So you really have a lot in your chart that is suggesting this motivation now to move forward with an educational pursuit. It's also religion. Okay, the 12th house is spirituality. The ninth house is organized religion. And there might be a really kind of radical desire to immerse yourself more in faith, in a religious belief system. And it might even be a little unusual since we're talking about Aquarius Uranian energy. But even if it's not, there's a desire to immerse yourself in this. The ninth house also connects to publishing, broadcasting, and advertising. So perhaps there's a push in one of these areas for you that's beginning now. And it's important because, again, Mars is hanging out here for a while. So eventually you'll be re-strategizing your approach to a ninth house matter. But for now, it's all about the spark, the motivation that's happening here for you. So let's pay attention to what that is for you, Gemini, in the month of May. Now, another event in May has to do with your personal relationships. There will be a full moon on the end of the month, on the 29th, actually. And it falls in your seventh house of partnership, of relationship. This full moon is illuminating something important for you, Gemini, connected to a personal relationship, whether it's in your business life or in your marriage or close committed partnership. Sometimes full moons can symbolize turning points and endings, but don't think that every full moon leads to an ending. That's just silly. The point of a full moon is awareness. It's illumination. So you're going to be illuminated about something in your personal life with a personal relationship or in business. And that illumination that you have at the end of the month, it's important. I do have to say that for some Geminis, there could be a disappointment connected to a business partnership or maybe a client if you're in your own business, possibly a disappointment or a disillusionment at the end of the month. And I am saying that only because that full moon is making a wide square to Neptune, which is at the top of your chart in your career sector. So that's a possibility for some, but not all of you. So Gemini, this month, there's so much going on for you mentally, intellectually, spiritually. If you feel that desire to shut the world away, you need to honor it, okay? You are going to be spending a lot more time on your own, doing you in a unique way, and you have to. You're supposed to. It's going to lead to phenomenal soul growth. Have a great month, Gemini.